Okay, everybody, and welcome back to Learn with Minecraft Education. Today we are looking at redstone and ways it can be used. We're just starting to look at the very basics of what redstone is before we move to some more advanced builds. Okay, now here in my hand I've got some redstone dust, and you'll see that if I place the redstone dust, it acts kind of like a circuit or like a piece of wire within a circuit. So we place it on top of a block, it doesn't create its own new block. And then we can link two items together, two objects together, using this to get them to interact with each other in different ways. So here, let me just move this cart back over here. There we go. Here we've got a detector rail, and it's linked via redstone to a redstone lamp. All right, so we move the cart onto the rail. There we go. And the detector rail detects the cart, sends a signal along the redstone and lights up the lamp. Here we have an observer. It's got an arrow on the top pointing in the direction it sends the signal, and on this side we are going to put a block, and as I destroy this block, as I mine it away, you will very briefly see the circuit turn to red and the door open, and then quickly it will turn back to its initial state and the door will close. Let's watch this. There we go, very quickly changed and opened the door there. Here we have a light sensor. So we are going to change the weather, not the weather, sorry, we're going to change the time to nighttime. So we're going to press forward slash. And we're going to type time set night. There we go. And as you can see, it's turned to night, and the piston, oops, the piston at the other end of this circuit here is in the closed position. And then if we go forward slash time set day, we'll see the light sensor activate and the piston will open. There we go, light sensor is receiving light, piston is open. Next, simple circuit here, we've got a pressure plate connected to a bell. So stand on the pressure plate and you can hear the bell ring. Next, a lever. So we're going to turn on the lever, and we've got a dragon's head at the other end, which starts moving its mouth up and down. The difference with the lever and the pressure plate, as soon as I step off the pressure plate, it stops sending the signal. The lever will wait for me to activate it again. So depending on the usage that you need for this, you can choose a lever or a pressure plate, for example. Here we have a button connected to a gate. There we are, signal comes on. And the button's kind of timed, so after a second or so, the button will pop back up and the gates will close. Here, we will have, if I place it down, a redstone torch. Okay, so I'll put the redstone torch down and it will send a signal through to the gate. There we are. And that will send a constant signal. And finally, we have a redstone block. Now, what I've done is connected this to a dispenser. And in the dispenser, I've put some fireworks. All right, so this will be a nice end to the video. I'm going to place the redstone block down, and it's launch a firework up into the sky. Okay, so there are obviously a lot of different ways you can use redstone. These are just some of the different items in Minecraft that we can link together with redstone, and hopefully this will give you and or your students some ideas of some of the kind of things that you can create. And obviously we want to teach our students these tools of how they can use redstone, and then let them get creative with it and see what they can make. And we will be looking at some ideas in further videos, so please do like and subscribe and stay tuned for that. But in the meantime, let your students explore redstone, see what they can do with some of these different ideas, get them to a build challenge using redstone, maybe a house with doors that open. Pistons can do lots of interesting things as well, and it's just taking us a little step further about some of the things Minecraft education can make for us. Okay, right, thanks for tuning in, and goodbye.